It was mid-afternoon, and it's funny, I can still remember the smell of honeysuckle all along that block. I was thinking about that dame upstairs, the way she had looked at me, and I wanted to see her again, close. She liked me. I could feel that. The way you feel when the cards are falling right for you. With a nice little pile of blue and yellow chips in the middle of the table. Only what I didn't know then was that I wasn't playing her. She was playing me with a deck of marked cards. The stakes weren't any blue and yellow chips. They were dynamite. Men should think twice before making widowhood woman's only path to power.
The French phrase femme fatale literally means deadly woman. She is sensuous and dangerous, either physically or emotionally, to her victims.
I knew then what I had done. I killed a man. I'd killed a man to get a woman. I put myself in her power, so there was one person in the world that could point a finger at me, and I would have to die. I had done that all for her, and I never want to see her again as long as I lived. I sat down on the edge of a deep, soft chair and looked at her. She was worth a stare. She was trouble. I stared at her legs. They seemed to be arranged to stare at. They were visible to the knee and one of them well beyond. The knees were dimpled, not bony and sharp. The calves were beautiful, the ankles long and slim and with enough melodic line for a tone poem. She was damn good looking. She wore a slipover and a skirt, and her hair was brushed back like a boy's. She started all that. She was built with curves like the hull of a racing yacht.
The sexual urge is shaped by society. Even animals have to learn how to be sexual. It is learning, rather than instinct, anthropologists now believe, which leads to successful reproductive behavior. Lab-raised monkeys are inept at sex, and human beings must also learn from external cues how to be sexual.
I knew what she was, and it made no difference at all. She was hard, as ruthless as she was beautiful, as brittle as bone china.
In a world ordered by sexual imbalance, pleasure in looking has been split between the active, male, and the passive, female. In their traditional exhibitionist role, women are simultaneously looked at and displayed, with their appearance coded for strong erotic impact, so they can be said to connote looked-atness.
She had a face a man could hang a dream on, a body that made Venus de Milo look all thumbs, and only the floor kept her legs from going on forever. To him, she was so beautiful, so seductive, so different from ordinary people, that he couldn't understand why no one was as disturbed as he by the clicking of her heels on the paved stones. Why no one else's heart was wild with the breeze stirred by the size of her veils. Why everyone didn't go mad with the movements of her braid, the flight of her hands, the gold of her laughter. He hadn't missed a single one of her gestures, not one of the indications of her character. But he didn't dare approach her for fear of destroying the spell. Wise men never say what they think of women.
Why does Samuel Butler say, wise men never say what they think of women? Wise men never say anything else, apparently. She walks in beauty, like the night, of cloudless climes and starry skies. And all that's best of dark and bright meet in her aspect and her eyes.
Some women choose to follow men, and some choose to follow their dreams. If you're wondering which way to go, remember that your career will never wake up and tell you that it doesn't love you anymore. I wasn't drawn to acting because I wanted to be desired. I was drawn to acting because I felt it would allow me to become the whole, embodied person I remembered being in childhood. One that could imagine freely, listen deeply, and feel wholeheartedly.
I grew up wishing for protectors, strangers to carry my bags, truck drivers to whistle out windows. I will never be feminine, and feminine in the worst way. Submissive, dependent, soft-spoken, coquettish. I was no good at any of it, no good at being a girl. On the other hand, I'm not half bad at being a woman. I am too intelligent, too demanding, and too resourceful for anyone to be able to take charge of me entirely. No one knows me or loves me completely. I have only myself.
She's an assassin, a spy, a soldier, a superhero, a CEO. She can make a wound compress out of a maxi pad while on a lam. Physical prowess, linear ambition, focused rationality. It's difficult for us to imagine femininity itself, empathy, vulnerability, listening, as strong. When I look at the world that stories have helped us envision, these are the very qualities that have been vanquished in favor of an overwrought masculinity.
Women have burned like beacons in all the works of all the poets from the beginning of time. Clytemnestra, Antigone, Cleopatra, Lady Macbeth, Phaedra, Cressida, Rosalind, Desdemona, the Duchess of Malfi, among the dramatists. Then among the prose writers, Millamant, Clarissa, Becky Sharp, Anna Karenina, Emma Bovary. The names flock to mind. Nor do they recall women lacking in personality and character. Indeed, if woman had no existence save in the fiction written by men, one would imagine her a person of the utmost importance. Very various, heroic and mean, splendid and sordid, infinitely beautiful and hideous in the extreme, as great as a man, some think even greater. I am not free while any woman is unfree, even when her shackles are very different from my own. I have chosen to no longer be apologetic for my femaleness and my femininity, and I want to be respected in all of my femaleness, because I deserve to be.
Men act and women appear. Men look at women. Women watch themselves being looked at. This determines not only most relations between men and women, but also the relations of women to themselves. The surveyor of women in herself is male, the surveyed female. Thus, she turns herself into an object, most particularly an object of vision, a sight.
The emerging woman will be strong-minded, strong-hearted, strong-souled, and strong-bodied. Strength and beauty must go together. Each time a woman stands up for herself, without knowing it, possibly, without claiming it, she stands up for all women.
straightforward, genuine, authentic woman without mean-mindedness, uncompromising, but at the same time understanding, indulgent, sensitive, deeply feeling, intensely aware of things and of people, passionately devoted to those she loved and created happiness for them. A fine life, serene, full, harmonious. It is dark. I cannot see myself anymore. And what do the others see? Maybe something hideous. ¶¶